friends. Today I am going to discuss about the significance of the non-cooperation movement. In my previous videos, I have already discussed about what all happened in the non-cooperation movement. So let's not waste the time. We'll talk about significance of non-cooperation movement. The movement started in the year 1920 and it was called off by Gandhiji in the year 1922. Now this had a this movement has a great significance, reason being first time a mass movement was organized in India, and khadi, charkha, these two were used as a common symbol during this movement. To popularize the Swadeshi cause, Gandhiji wanted people to use charkha and use hand spun cloth, that is khadi, for giving a support to the indigenous industry, and this will help in reducing our dependency on the foreign goods, right? So charkha became a common symbol. It was adopted in the tricolor flag of India at that time, and khadi was commonly used. People started using khadi in their day-to-day life, right? Then satyagraha introduced by the Gandhiji, satyagraha and non-cooperation, these two ideologies were incorporated by Indian National Congress. They adopted these ideologies, and it started changing the character of the Congress. More and more leaders in the Congress, they started following the Gandhian ideologies, right? And as Gandhiji wanted to rebuild a unity between the Hindus and the Muslims by giving support, by launching this movement, he wanted to give support to the Khilafat cause also. And this happened. And during the movement, the Hindu-Muslim unity was clearly seen. Right, so these were some of the important things that happened during the non-cooperation movement. But besides these facts, the movement became quite slow. In its initial phase, it was the people in India, they enthusiastically participated in the movement, but later on it became quite slow due to many reasons. One reason was that the students who were boycotting the foreign institution like schools and colleges, they do not find place for themselves in indigenous institutions, because there were no alternative institutions there in India, right? Then the khadi cloth, no doubt people used, they adopted khadi, but many high class Indians, they were not in, they didn't accept it khadi. Moreover, khadi was quite expensive as compared to the foreign cloth, reason being it was hand spun, and it was quite expensive as compared to the foreign cloth. Right, so people in India, many people, they were not in a condition to afford such an expensive cloth. Then the idea of Swadeshi was not worked out at that time, reason being indigenous industries were not present on a large scale at that time to fulfill the demands of Indians. So somewhere people half-heartedly, they were supporting these cause. So things happened, all these things happened during the non-cooperation movement, and these were the reasons the movement became quite slow in its later stages. Now when the movement was called off, what happened next politically, that within Congress, there were leaders who became quite disappointed why Gandhiji called off the movement. And they had this idea that if we want to bring a change, if we want to seek rights for ourselves, then we have to be part of the legislative council. And such leaders who were believing, who were having this ideology, they were called as pro-changers. Leaders like C.R. Das, Chittaranjan Das and Motilal Nehru, these leaders were of this view that if we want to be, if we are in the legislative council, we can put our demand more effectively, we can pressurize the government, and side by side we can expose the evil deeds of the government, right? So such leaders were called pro-changers, and there were leaders in the Congress who doesn't want to support this idea. So there, like Subhash Chandra Bose, like Dada Bhai Nauroji, like Lala Lajpat Rai, so they didn't supported this idea. They were called no changers. So Congress were again in a stage where two groups were formed, pro changers and no changers, and ultimately the pro changers made a separate party called the Swaraj Party in the year 1922, and this party at that time was headed by C.R. Das, Chittaranjan Das. So this is all about the Swaraj Party. Please like, share and review this video and wait for the next video. Thank you.